गुड इवनिंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट वर्कशीट 6 एंड वर्कशीट 7 फ्रॉम एल्जेब्रिक आइडेंटिटीज एंड दिस इज द लास्ट सेशन ऑफ दिस चैप्टर एंड वी विल कंप्लीट दिस चैप्टर इन दिस सेशन. सो देर आर टू वर्कशीट्स रिमेनिंग, वर्कशीट 6 एंड वर्कशीट 7. सो द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम वर्कशीट 6 इज फैक्टराइज. नाउ बिफोर फैक्टराइज दिस एक्सप्रेशन, जस्ट रिकॉल द थ्री आइडेंटिटीज दैट वी हैव लर्न फ्रॉम the beginning of this chapter. The three identities are your, that is a plus b whole square is equals to a square plus 2ab plus b square. This was your identity 1. Second identity was a minus b whole square equals to a square minus 2ab plus b square. And the third identity was your a plus b a minus b equals to a square minus b square. Clear? So identity 1, identity 2 and identity 3, just look at these identities very carefully, because these identities we will have to use to factorize these questions, that is particularly from worksheet 6, and also it will help in your worksheet 7 also. Clear? Now if you closely look this expression, you will see that the first term is your a square, the second term is your ab, and the third one is your b square. Clear? Just closely look first two expressions. The first term will be your a square, the first term will be your a square, the second term will be your ab, and the third term will be your b square. So we will arrange these expressions according to this pattern. Clear? At first we will arrange these expressions in this pattern. If not arranged in question, we will arrange this expression in this pattern. Just understand this first. Clear? First term is your a square, second term is your ab, and the third term will be your b square. We will arrange these questions at this pattern. Clear? If it is not arranged in the question, but if it is arranged, then there is no question about that. Clear? So just we will start factorizing. So worksheet 6, the first question. First questions from your worksheet 6, the first question is your x square plus z square minus 2x. Now see, this is the first term, x square. Now just compare this, compare the question with the property. What I have told you, I told you that this will be your first term, ab will be your second term, and the b square will be your third term. Clear? So this was your first term and z square. So just compare this identity with the question. This will be your third term, this should be your third term, and this should be your second term. Clear? Because ab is your second term, that means here is xz, here is xz, here ab means here xz, so that will be your second term, that means it will come to xz, and this will go. So we will arrange this at this pattern if it is not arranged in the question. Clear? Then we will factorize. But if it is arranged, then there is no question to arrange it. Clear? So just try to break this expression into this formula. Clear? That means the formula a square plus 2ab plus a square plus 2ab plus b square, this format is given in your question, and you have to do from this expression to this expression. That means a square plus 2ab plus b square is given, and you will convert that into a plus b whole square form. That is your factorization. Clear? That means a square plus 2ab plus b square is given in this format, and you will just convert that into a plus b whole square. Clear? So just try to convert. That means this is x square, so we can write like this. This is x square minus, the formula is your 2ab, so 2a is your x, b is your z, 2ab plus b square. Clear? So I have after arranging these terms, just I break this into the formula. So just clearly see which identity here is used. The identity here is used, your identity 2, number 2. This is your identity 1, this was your identity 2, and this was your identity 3. So second identity is used, because the second identity, one sign is minus and the another sign is plus. So in the question, here also one sign is your minus and the another sign is your plus. So identity second is matched, because identity 1 contains both the plus sign. Clear? That means your identity 2 is matched. So if you compare identity 2 with the question, you can clearly see that I have just first arrange the question, the terms, and then I have just compare and break as pattern. Clear? That means x square minus 2xz plus z square will be written like this. That means x whole square minus 2 into x into z, and z square. That means if x is considered as your a, x is considered as your a and z as b, so the formula is, that is a square minus 2ab plus b square. Clear? A square minus 2ab plus b square. That means the formula is your a minus b whole square, and a is your x, b is your z, so that is x minus z whole square. So this is x minus z whole square, this is x minus z whole square, or conversely you can write, this is x minus z and x minus z. This is your answer, x minus z and x minus z, this is your answer. Clear? This is your answer. So just don't try to write these in your exam. I have just written to just to make you understand that I have compared the identity with this. Clear? So this is your answer. In this way we will solve these questions by comparing the identities with the given question. So second question is your question number 4. Question number 14 is your 121 p square plus 16 q square minus 88 p cube. So just arrange first, because it is not in, because it is not arranged in the question. So this is your first term. That means if you compare, now here see, one is plus sign and one is minus sign. Clear? So identity 2 is matched, one is minus sign, one is plus sign. So identity 2 is matched. Clear? Because identity 1 contains both the plus sign. So identity is not matched here. The identity 2 is matched, because identity 2 has one minus sign and one plus sign, and also the given question has one minus sign and one plus sign. But if this is your first term, so 121 p square is your first term. Now look at this, 2ab will be your second term. 2ab should second term. So here 2ab means this. This is your 2ab form. If you compare 2ab with 88pq, this is your 2ab form, because here a is your p, here a is your p and b is your q. Here a is your p and b is your q. That means 2ab is actually 88pq, and 88pq should be in your second term, as 2ab is the second term. So you will arrange it like this. Clear? And then 16q square. Clear? So I have arranged this. So here if you compare here, that means 121 p square minus 88pq plus 16q square. Now 121 means 121 is 11 square. That means 11p square. So this is your a square, because the formula is a square minus 2ab plus b square. So you will arrange like this. So 11p square, that means 11p will be your a. Clear? Now 2ab, here it is 2ab. So 2ab means 2 into a. A is your 11p. So 2a. Clear? Now b also here. So what is the b? What is the b? Now just see, 2 into 11 means 22. 22p, and here is 88pq. That means 2 into 11 means 22, and it is 88. That means we have to multiply 4 with 22 so that it will give you 88. Clear? I am repeating again. This is 22. That means 2 into a into b, a is 11p. That means it is 11p, and a b should be written here. So what is the value of b? See, this is 88pq, and this is 2 into 11, that means 22. So if you multiply 22 with 4, that will gives you 88. So that means it is 4q, because it is 88pq. That means 2 into 11, 22, and 4, 88, and pq means pq. So this is your b. That means 2ab, this is your a. So 2ab, so b is your 4q. Now the third term is your b square. So b is your 4q. That means it will be b square. B means 4q, that is b square. That means 4q square. 4q square means 4q into 4q. That means 4 4s are 16. Qqs are q square. That means 16q square. It is already matched. That means a square minus 2ab plus b square. We have compared this question using the identity 2, and it is already matched. Therefore, What is the formula of identity 2? It is a minus b whole square. That means a is your 11p, b is your 4q. That is 11 minus p minus 4q square. So this is 11p minus 4q. 11p minus 4q. So this is your answer. Clear? As here is square term, so we will write two times. This is your answer. Clear? So we in this question we will just find suitable identity. We will first find suitable identity and then we will rearrange this if it is not arranged in question, and then we will break this with the identity and we will have our answer. Clear? So next question is your question number 5. Question number 5 is your 9x square y minus 24x y square plus 16 y to the power 3. Clear? 9x square y minus 24xy square plus 16y to the power 3. Clear? Now see, this is 9x square y. Clear? Now see here, one is this is y, 1y, 2y and 3y. Clear? 1y, 2y and 3y. So we will take y as a common, because we cannot take out x as a common, because x is only in the first term, and in the second term there is no x in third term, so we cannot take common x. We will take common y, because y in all the three terms there is y is present. So here is only 1y, here is 2y, here is 3y. So we will take y as a common, because we cannot take y2 common, we cannot take y3 common. Minimum number of y is 1. It is 1y, it is 2y, it is 3y. Clear? So we will take y as a common. So just first take y as a common. That means it is 9x square, it is 24xy, it is 16y square. Clear? If you take y as a common, it is 9x square minus 24xy plus 16y square, because if you 24xy means 24xy into y, that is 24xy square, and 16y square y means 16y to the power 3. Clear? So now this is your a square minus, if you compare, there is one is minus sign, one is plus sign. That means only two contains one minus sign, one plus sign. That means this is the property we will use to solve this question, because signs are matched. That means this is the first term, this is the second term, and this is the third term. Now see, here the all the identities, all the terms are properly arranged. We need not arrange this question. All the terms are properly arranged. If you compare with a square minus 2ab plus b square, all the terms are properly arranged. That means 9x square is your first term, and 2ab, ab means here xy, so that is your second term, and lastly b square, that means 16y square will be your last term. Here y should be taken as common. If you cannot take y common, you cannot solve this question. Clear? Because this form doesn't support the identity 2. Because if you compare this this form with your identity 2, you cannot solve this question, because this form is not supported with identity 2. You will have to take y as a common. Only then you can solve this question by comparing it with identity 2. Clear? Now break. So this is y. Clear? Now 9x square means 3x whole square. That means 9x square. Clear? This will be your second bracket. Minus, the formula is 2ab. Formula is 2ab. So this is your a actually. So 2a, a means 3x. Clear? So 2a, now formula is 2ab. So what is the value of b? Now see, if you are breaking this part, you are breaking this part. That means 2, 3 is a 6, and it is 24 here. That means we will multiply 4 to get 24. That means 4. Now 2, 3 is a 6, 6, 4 is a 24. 24x, and it is y here. That means we will multiply y also. That is 24xy. So this is your b. So 2ab. Clear? Plus b square. Formula plus b square. So b is your 4y. So b square. That means 4y square. And 4y square means 4y into 4y, that means 4 4s are 16, yy's are y square, so there is 16y square, so it is already matched. Clear? So we will just do the formula. That means the formula is a minus b whole square. So a is your 3x, b is your 4y. So a minus b whole square means 3x minus 4y, this is whole square. That means this will be y, we will write y as it is, 3x minus 4y. This is your answer. Clear? This will be your answer. Clear? Next. Last question from this worksheet. Actually, these are very easy questions. If you follow my instruction, what I have taught in the previous lessons and what I am teaching to you right now, if you catch up my words, you will easily do these sums. Clear? Just listen to this lesson very carefully and follow my instructions. Question 7. Question 7 says 50 a square plus 98 b square plus 140 ab. Clear? Now see, this question also is not arranged. How do you know this question is not arranged? Because if you compare the question, now see, in the question both are plus sign. Now see the identity. The identity 1 contains both plus sign. That means identity 1 is matched. That means we will use identity 1 with this question because signs are matched. Clear? Now a square plus 2ab plus b square, that means 2ab is the second term. Here 2ab is this is the your 2ab form. That means this will be the second term, and second term means this will be in your middle. So you will arrange it first, because it is not arranged. So we will first check whether the given question is arranged or not. Now 50 a square plus 140ab plus 98b square. Clear? Now see that 50 is not a square number. Clear? But 50 is not a square number. We cannot square 50. Why? But in the formula it says a square. That means a should be a number that can be squared. The formula is a square plus 2ab plus b square. That means here we will square the number so that we can use it in the formula. But 50, a number which cannot be squared. You cannot square 50. You cannot square 50. So how can you solve this question? Clear? Just listen carefully. The formula is a square plus 2ab plus b square. That means a square. That means we will have to square this number. That means we will have to square 50. If it is 64, suppose if it was 64, we can easily do this 8a whole square. That means 64. But we cannot do this with 50. Clear? We cannot do this to 50. It cannot be squared. So in that situation, we will take common. In that situation, we will take common. Common means we will take some common from these three numbers. We will take common among these three numbers, that is 50, 140 and 98. We will take common. Clear? We will take common from these three numbers. Here common should be, what is the common number? We will take common 2. Because we will take common 2. Why? How do you know that 2 should be taken as a common? How do you know 2 should be taken as a common? In this case, just 50, 140 and 98, to take common or to choose common between 50, 140 and 98, just HCF this number. Just do HCF of this number. The HCF, the answer of this will be your common. Just do HCF, that means 50, 140, 98. Just do HCF. 25, 70, 49. So 2 is your HCF. 2 is your HCF, that means 2 should be taken as a common. I am repeating again, that means in this case, whenever you cannot do square any number, you will have to take common. Clear? So what number you will take common? Just do the HCF. The HCF is your 2, and 2 will be taken as a common. The HCF should be taken as a common. Clear? So 2 should be taken as a common. The HCF should be taken as a common. Here HCF is 2. So you will take 2 as a common. Now this is 25 a square, that means 50 a square plus this is 70, so that 270s are 140 ab, plus this is 49, so that 249s are 98. This is b square. Clear? Now you will easily square this number. That means you can easily do 5a whole square, so that it will be 25a square. Clear? So just write 2, this is 5a whole square. That means 25a square, 5a into 5a, 5 5s are 25, a's are a square, 25a square, plus 2ab, so 2 into what is a, this is your a, 5a is your a actually. टोटल 5a एक्चुअली इज योर a, क्लियर. सो 2ab, a इज योर 5a, एंड व्हाट इज द वैल्यू ऑफ b. नाउ यू आर ब्रेकिंग दिस पार्ट, यू आर ब्रेकिंग दिस पार्ट, दिस इज एक्चुअली योर 2ab पार्ट. इफ यू कंपेयर द आइडेंटिटी, दिस इज एक्चुअली 2ab, सो दिस इज द 2ab पार्ट. नाउ 2 into a, a इज 5a, दैट मीन्स 10a, दिस इज 10a, एंड एक्चुअली दिस इज 70, सो 2 5s आर 10. So we will multiply 7 with 10 to get 70. So this is your 7, and there is b, this is 7b, that means 70ab. So this is your a part and this is your b part. So this is the value of b. The next time is your b square. So b is your 7b, that means 7b square, that means 7b into 7b, that means 49b square, clear. So I did this, don't try to write this in exam, clear. I have just written to make you better understand. That means the formula is your a square plus 2ab plus b square. The formula is a plus b whole square. That is a plus b whole square. So the answer is 5a plus 7b. 5a plus 7, because here is 2 is written here. That means you will break into two parts. So this is your answer. Clear? So we will solve these questions with the help of this formula, these identities, and in this way we will solve this question. So worksheet 6 is here complete. Next, coming to worksheet 7. Worksheet 7 is little bit tricky, clear. The questions worksheet 7 also the factorized question, but this is a special term. That means this term is known as middle term factorization. This term is known as middle term factorization. Worksheet 7, the questions from worksheet 7 are the middle term factorization. That means we will break this middle portion, middle term. Clear? So number one question from worksheet 7 is here, x square plus 14x plus 33. Now listen carefully. So this is the middle term factorization. Now if you compare this question with any of this identity, that is identity 1, identity 2 and identity 3, no identity is matched. Clear? No identity is matched. Clearly see, that is x square plus 14x plus 33. This is the constant term. This is the constant term. Clear? So if you compare this question with the identities given, you cannot compare because no identity is matched. Clear? That means these questions are somewhat different from the questions from worksheet 6. Because the last time you see this term, this is a constant term. Clear? And in this identity, no term is constant. Every term is variable. A, B, everything is variable. No constant term is here. But here, one term, that is the last term, is the constant term. Because we know numbers are constant actually. And here, no constant is present. That means this question is not solved. We cannot solve this question using this identity. Clear? So, in this question, in this type of questions, we will break the second term. That means this term, we will break the second term. We will break the second term. So that, we will break the second term with the help of this constant. I am repeating again. Listen carefully. In this type of question, we will break the second term with the help of the constant. With the help of the constant. Now check. So we will break the second term with the help of this constant. Now the constant is a 33. So break 33. That is 3 elevens of 33. Now the middle term is your plus 40. We will consider the plus sign. We will consider the plus sign. Clear? The middle term is plus 40. So write plus 14 here. So the 33 is 3 and 11. So we will calculate 3 and 11 in such a way so that we will get plus 40. I am repeating again. You will break the middle term with the help of this constant. We will break the middle term with the help of this constant. So middle term is your plus 14 and the constant is 33. Now break 33, you will get 3 and 11. Now this 3 and 11, we will calculate 3 and 11. That means we can add 3 and 11, we can multiply 3 and 11, we can divide 3 and 11, we can subtract 3 and 11, anything, clear? Any operation you can do, that is addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, so that you will get plus 40. Clear? You will calculate 3 and 11 by any means. You can do addition, you can do subtraction, you can do division, you can do multiplication in anything. But you have to achieve plus 14 using 3 and 11. So how can we achieve plus 14 using 3 and 11? Only if you add 11 plus 3. Only then you can achieve plus 14. Listen, we will consider the sign. We will consider the sign while calculating. Clear? So this will be your 14 plus 14. Now here is x. Here is x over here, 14x. Therefore, you will just multiply x so that you will have 14x. Clear? So we will write 11x plus 3x instead of 14x over here. Clear? Now write x square plus 11x plus 3x plus 33. Clear? So we will write 11x plus 3x in place of 14x. Clear? Alternatively, you can write 3x and 11x. Both are correct. Clear? Both are correct. You can write 11 here. Also, you can write 11 here. Both are correct. Clear? Now take out common. Now take out common. If you take common, x, take x as a common, so it is x plus 3. And take common 11. Take out 11 as a common, because 11 3s are 33. So if you take 11 as a common, this is your x and this is 3. So 11x plus 33. That means x plus 3. Take out x plus 3 common. So x plus 11 will be remaining. So this is your answer. Clear? So this type of questions is very important. This type of questions is known as middle term factorization. Why middle term factorization? Because you are breaking the middle term. That's why this is known as middle term factorization. So in this middle term factorization, we will break the middle term with the help of this constant. Clear? Now the constant is 33, so we will break 33, that is 3 and 11. Now the middle term is plus 14, we will consider the plus sign. Now by any means, you will have to achieve plus 14 using these two numbers. You can do addition, you can do subtraction, you can do division, you can do multiplication, anything. But you will have to achieve plus 14 at any cost using these two numbers. You cannot take other numbers except 11 and 3. You will have to take only 11 and 3. So only one way we can achieve plus 14 using 11 and 3 is that whenever you add 11 plus 3, that will gives you plus 14. Now as here x is attached, 14x is here, so you will attach x over here, that means it's 14x plus 14x. So you will write 11 plus 3x instead of 14x. Now take out as common. So the answer is your x plus 3, x plus 11. Clear? Next question is question number 5. Question number 5 is y square plus y minus 132. Clear? So same type of question, just break 132. Just break this y using the constant. Now here no term is given. In the previous question, here 14 is given. Here 14 is given with x, but here no term is given, no number is given with y. In this case, we will consider 1. If no number is given with the middle term, we will consider it as a 1. Clear? We will consider it as a 1 if no number is given. That means your middle number is plus 1. Therefore, the middle number is plus 1. Therefore, we will break this 132 so that we will achieve plus 1. Clear? Okay. Next, so try to break 132 so that you can achieve plus 1. So if you break 132 using 11, that means this will give you 11 into 12. 11 into 12 is your 132. So only one way by which you can achieve plus 1 using 12 and 11, only these two numbers, is when you will minus just 12 minus 11, you will have plus 1. Clear? Now as it is y given here, as 1 is attached to y, therefore this will be your y, this will be your y, this is y. So you will have plus y. Clear? So we will write 12y minus 11y instead of y. Clear? That means we will write 12y minus 11y minus 132. This will be your plus y. Look at this. So we have just substitute the value of y, that is 12y minus 11y. Clear? Now take out as common. So y square y from these two term. Here is 1y, here is 2y. So take y as a common, 1y. This is y plus 12. That means y square plus 12y. Clear? Now it is y plus 12. Clear? So as it is y plus 12, here also y plus 12 should be present, because you cannot take out common. Here the one term is y plus 12, here one term is your y plus 12. Clear? So in these two term, between these two term, when you take out common, also y plus 12 should be there. If it is not, you cannot take, you cannot solve the question. Clear? So between 11 and 132, what is common? Now clear to see, 11 into 12 are 132. That means 132 means 11 into 12. So in 132, one number is 11. Clear? So take out 11 as a common. If you take 11 as a common, that means 11y, and this is minus sign. Clear? That means minus 11y, minus plus or minus, 11 12 are 132. Clear or not? Clear or not? Now 11y minus 132, that means if you take 11 as a common, minus 11 as a common, that means minus 11y, and this whenever you multiply, this minus sign and plus sign will becomes minus. That means 11 into 12 are 132. Clear? Because 132 has already 11 into 12, that means 132 has already 11 term. So take out 11 as a common from 132. Clear? So now this is y plus 12 and this is also y plus 12, so that you can take out y plus 12 as a common. And this is your y minus 11. So this is your answer. Clear? Clear? This is the way we will solve this type of questions. Next. Question number 9. Question number 9 says p square minus 5p minus 6. Clear? So here the middle term is your minus 5. We will consider the sign also. Clear? The middle term is minus 5 and that the constant is 6. So we will break 6 in such a way so that we can achieve minus 5. So just break 6. So 2, 3 is a 6. There are two way to break 6. One is your 2, 3. So you can just minus 3 minus 2. That means it will get minus 5. Clear? We will have to get minus 5. We will have to get minus 5 by any means. We will have to get minus 5. Clear? So 2, 3 is a 6. If you add 2 plus 3, so that will give you plus 5, not minus 5. And you have to get minus 5. So only one way we can achieve, that means minus 3 minus 2. Because we know when both the sign is minus, the term will add. That means 3 2s are 5 and minus means minus 5. Clear? So this is minus 3 minus 2. And as p is attached here, so just add p. So that it is minus 5p. So instead of minus, in place of minus 5p, we will write minus 3p minus 2p. Clear or not? Clear? So we will write p square minus 3p minus 2p minus 6. Clear? That means it is minus 5. Now take out p as a common from here. P. So it is p minus 3. That means p square minus 3. And as here p minus 3 is the one term, so in this when you take out common, as it is a p minus 3, as one term is p minus 3, so it also contains p minus 3. Because if it is not p minus 3, so you cannot common this term. I am repeating again, as this term contains a p minus 3 as a common part, so when you want to take common this number, this common part also will contain p minus 3. If it is not p minus 3, then you cannot take out common. That means you cannot solve the question. Clear? So 2 and 6, so what number will take common? Take 2 as a common. If you take 2 as a common, because 6 contains already 2. 6 has 2 part, because 6 equals to 2 into 3, because already 6 contains 2. So if you take 2 as a common, that means 2p, and here it is plus. Clear? That means 2p, and plus minus minus, 2, 3 is a 6. Just match whenever you want to, you will take common. Just match this signs and digits as well as digits. So 2p, that is, this is your minus 2p. So we'll take minus as common. If you take minus as common, that means minus 2p, minus 2p. But minus minus are plus 6, but here is here the sign is minus. That means you cannot break using 6 as 2 into 3. Clear? Just try to understand what I am trying to say is that minus 2, if you take minus 2 as a common, you can take between 2 and 6, you can take 2 as a common. Clear? So if you take 2 as a common, that means 2p and minus minus plus 6, but here the sign is minus, that means this conversion is not possible. If you take plus 2 as a common, that means 2p, 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 and plus minus and minus, that means 2, 3 is a 6, but here is minus 2p and you are calculating plus 2p. So this is also not possible. Clear? That means you cannot break 6 as 2 into 3. This break is not possible. Clear? So how we'll solve this question now? Just this is a very important question, because 6 can be break, you can break 6 into two form. One is your 2 and 3, and one is your 6 1. Clear? You can break the constant 6 by these two process. One is your 2 3 is a 6, one is your 6 1 is a 6. Now this 2 3 when you will do 2 into 3 6, this conversion is not possible, because whenever you are trying to solve by breaking it 2 into 3, you will see that you cannot take common. The sign will not match. Therefore, this path is not possible. So the only way is 6 into 1 is 6. Now we will have to arrive in the middle term, that is minus 5. So by calculating the two digits 6 and 1, we will arrive the digit minus 5. So there is only one way by which we can achieve, that is 1 minus 6. It is 1 minus 6. If you do 1 minus 6 only, it is minus 5. Clear? Now there is P attached. So just attach P. That means minus 5P. That means 1P means, 1P means actually P. So P minus 6P. So we will write P minus 6P instead of minus 5P. So just try to write P square minus P minus 6P. Minus 6. Clear? There is P minus 6P is where minus 5P. So you will write plus P minus 6P, because there is 1 and 6, so you will write 1 minus 6, that gives you a minus 5 actually. This will gives you minus 5, 1 minus 6, if here P is attached. So just try to attach P. That means this is 1P minus 6P, that means P minus 6P. 1P means P, 1 is actually negligible, so P minus 6, so you write P minus 6P. Clear? Before 1, it is a plus sign, because by default, plus sign is present before any number. Clear? So this is plus P, that is plus P. Clear? Now take out P as a common. Therefore, if you take out P as a common, it is P plus 1. Clear? Now take 6 as a common. If you take 6 as a common, here is P plus 1. So this term also contains P plus 1. That is P plus 1. Now this is minus. Now try to match minus 6P and minus plus are minus. This is minus 6. So take out P plus 1. Here also P plus 1. Take out P plus 1 is common. That is P minus 6. So this is your answer. Clear? Whenever you are trying to take common or factorize, just try to match the symbols given. Clear? Minus 6p, minus plus and minus. So p plus 1, p minus 6 is the answer. Next question. Next question is your question number 11. So question number 9 is very important. Okay? Question number 11. X square minus 8x minus 65. Clear? So middle term is your minus 8. So we'll break this constant term. We'll break this constant term to arrive at minus 8. So this is 65. So try to break 5 13s are 65, and you have to achieve minus 8 using this 5 and 13. So there is only one way you can achieve, that is 5 minus 13. This will gives you minus 8, because if you do 13 minus 5, this will gives you plus 8, not minus 8, and we will consider the minus sign. That means you will take 5 minus 13, that will only give you minus 8. Now here is x is attached over here, so attach x, that is minus 8x, that is 5x minus 13x. We will write 5x minus 13x instead of minus 8x, so that we will have minus 8x. Now there is no sign before 5x, that means the sign is plus, because by default the sign is plus. That means we will write plus 5x minus 13x, so that you will have minus 8x common, minus 8x. So just try to write x square plus 5x minus 13x minus 65. Clear? Now take x as a common, x plus 5, and here is 13 and 65. So what we will take? 13 and 65. 65 already has 13, because 65 is 13 into 5. So take out 13 as common. If you take 13 as a common, this will be x plus 5. Clear? Because minus 13x, minus 13x, minus plus are minus, 13 5s are 65. So it is already matched. And here also x plus 5, here also x plus 5. If one term is x plus 5 here, this term also should x minus 5, x plus 5. If here is one term x plus 5, then this term must contain x plus 5. If it is not x plus 5, then you cannot take out common. Clear? So x plus 5, x plus 5. So 1 x plus 5 is common. You are taking 1 x plus 5 common between these two x plus 5. So if it is x plus 5, then this term must contain x plus 5. so that you can take common 1x plus 5 between these 2x plus 5. Clear? So this is x minus 13. X minus 13. So this is your answer. Clear? So x minus 13, this is the answer. Now question number 16. Question number 16 says p square minus 3pq plus 2q square. Now p square minus 3pq plus 2q square. Clear? P square minus 3pq plus 2q square. This is also an important sum. Just try to understand this sum. So the middle term is your minus 3. Middle term is your minus 3. And this is the constant term. 2. This is the constant term. Clear? So we will break constant term to achieve minus 3. We will consider the sign also. Clear? So just try to break 2, the constant term. So 2 ones are 2. So you will use 2 and 1 to achieve minus 3. So the only way we can achieve minus 3 of using 2 and 1, that is minus 2 minus 1, this will give you minus 3. Clear? Now here pq is attached with minus 3. So to achieve minus 3, here is 3pq. So to achieve minus 3pq, you will attach minus pq and minus pq. That means minus 2pq and minus pq. Because 1pq is actually pq. Clear? 1pq means pq. So minus 2pq and minus pq will give you minus 3pq. So instead, in place of minus 3pq, we will write minus 2pq minus pq. Clear? Minus 2pq and minus pq, that is your minus 3pq plus 2q square. Now take out common p and p, so you will take p as common. So this is p, that is p square, minus here is 2pq, here is p, so that is 2q, so that it is 2pq. Clear? Next, if this term contains p minus 2q, then this term, when you will take common, this term also contain p minus 2q. This term also contain p minus 2q. This you should understand this fact very well, because if this term has p minus 2q, this term must contain p minus 2q. Clear? Now here is p, here is q also, so take out q as a common. Clear? Now try to match with the above line. There is minus qp will multiply minus pq minus pq, minus plus, minus minus are plus, minus minus are plus, 2qq 2q square. It is already matched. Clear? Now take out, here is p minus 2q, here is p minus 2q, so take out 1 p minus 2q, it is p minus q. So this is the answer. Clear? So this way we will solve these questions. In this way we will solve this middle term factorization questions. Just try to do remaining sums. These two questions will solve by you in the homework. 15 and 7, these are very easy questions. 15 and 7, so these is worksheet 7. The very important questions these are. Clear? So the chapter is complete. Clear? Try to solve the remaining questions in your homework copy, and I will check them as soon as possible after the lockdown. Clear? Thank you.